Brian, what are you doing?
Fixing things. What are you doing?
Dude, we have a video to make.
Ow! Oh!
And oh, are we really excited? This is a Rock LIX. Let's open it up, shall we? This is gonna be a two-man job. One person can't have the pleasure of opening this up by himself.
That's true. Damn.
Look at that. What is this? Look at that. They even doubled our stands. Look at that. Basically cut it in half. What set off our tiki senses was the battery size. They've doubled it.
Cardboard.
Here, plug in.
Charger.
100 what?
Is it 100? 65. 65. It's not 45 like the Steam Deck, which is nice. We have...
paperwork. What? No stickers?
No stickers.
Oh, come on. Give us some stickers, man. It's like 700 bucks. We deserve some stickers. Not only that, but they doubled the storage from 512 gigabytes to 1 terabyte. Yeah, look at that. They even doubled the C-ports. Finally, a smart move. But interestingly enough, what hasn't doubled is the weight. It's barely heavier. About 70 grams heavier. Let's see what else is in here.
Sorry, get out of here. Let me move that. Did you see that? That thing got stuck.
What? It got stuck? Oh, they said it was tighter.
Wow.
Is it tighter? Oh, that's a heavy joystick. Now to the ROG LIX, the beast. And man, I gotta tell you, this thing looks so much better in black. So much more elegant.
Set it down.
It's taller. All right, so what's changed? Well, for one, the X is taller. From this point forward, I'll be referring to the white one as the original and the newest one as the X. Looking at the front, we can see that it's nearly identical. And you can tell that on the original, the joystick is much farther away from the edge than it is on the X. They're also farther down from the top. The D-pad is now different. You have 8 directions as opposed to the original where you only have 4 directions. So visibly different. I'm gonna measure it because that's what I do. It is bigger. The D-pad is bigger.
2 centimeters?
No. Speakers in the same exact place. Front facing you. How speakers should go.
What?
You know what?
Mr. Legion?
What? They're good.
Legion fanboy.
For who? Now, let's take a look at the back. You can instantly see the buttons are much smaller. My finger is bigger than it.
That's way smaller. Wow.
You don't need much, but why did they make them so small? I mean, this one looks like a proper button.
So you technically go down.
You go down?
Yeah, see that?
No, I'm not.
Yeah, me
too. Oh, so it was a joke. Oh. So from the back, pretty similar, other than the buttons. The casing is much higher. Is that gonna help with airflow? Is that gonna help with overheating? Looking at the side, you can instantly tell that the handles are quite bigger. Taking a look at the top view, we notice quite the amount of things. First, the vents. These ports are much bigger. Everything looks to have been kind of swapped around. From left to right, you see power buttons in the same place. Audio jack is now in a different place. Volume button is on the opposite side. SD slot is on the opposite side. And instead of having this huge proprietary GPU port, you get another vent. Triggers on the X are bigger. You're right. They feel the same, but they are bigger. Let's first talk about what remained the same. We still have the same OS, Windows 11, and the same processor, the Z1 Extreme. The display is the same 7-inch 1920x1080 LCD, and they both support refresh rates of 60 and 120 Hz. And they both have a 6-axis gyro. Juan absolutely loves gyro.
Because he's a noob.
Now here is where it all changes. Starting with the big one, we went from 16 gigabytes of RAM to 24 gigs.
Holy crap.
And the 40 watt hour battery is now 80 watt hours. You have doubled the battery life. Now, instead of the proprietary external GPU PCIe port, we have another Type-C. It supports 40 gigs per second. That is incredible. Let's quickly set this up and update it with what we need to. Finally done. Setup and updating took about an hour and a half. So many updates, similar to the old original one. But it's all fun and games until you start gaming.
No, it's still all fun and games.
No, you're right. You're right. But how good is it really? Let's play some games. So strap up and let's hell dive. There you go. My god. It's really, really smooth. This is like butter smooth.
Right.
This is 3080 smooth.
That is extremely playable.
Yeah.
No problem whatsoever, right?
I haven't messed with any settings.
You almost killed your teammate right there.
Yeah, he'll be fine. I knew it. As soon as I saw those mushrooms, I was like, I'm dead. Dude, this is... There is no screen tearing, no lag, no nothing. And look at everything going on around me.
Sound is fantastic. Going straight to your ears, right?
Yep. Straight in. At the end of the day, we can easily tell at surface level, it plays great and feels familiar because of my experience with the original ROG Ally. And yeah, for first impressions, I am impressed. Now, I haven't done any benchmarking, but I can tell you right now, it feels next level. But it is using the same processors. So to see how much of an upgrade this really is, we gotta do some serious testing and benchmarking. The whole nine yards. So join us in the next video when we put these guys up against each other. Then we'll see what's changed for better or for worse. And to see if the price difference is justified. So thank you again for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I really appreciate you. I'm Brim, and I'll see you next time. Later.